Guild Wars 2 has a fair amount of third-party add-ons that enhances your experience and makes playing the game a bit more fun. In this video, I will showcase some of these quality of life add-ons that I think everyone playing Guild Wars 2 should at the very least try out. First is Guild Wars 2 Radial. This add-on becomes more useful the more mounts you unlock, but it also has some other tricks up its sleeve. When you set up and press the key bind for Guild Wars 2 Radial, it will show all the mounts on your mouse, and all you have to do is move your mouse over slightly to select the one you want summoned. It makes switching between mounts incredibly easy and lets you perform tricks like these. When you press Alt Shift M, it will bring up the Guild Wars 2 Radial menu. Here you have to copy your mount keybinds from the game and then set a single keybind that will bring up the Radial mount selection menu. I like to have it as my extra mouse button, but you can use any on your keyboard and the radial menu will show up on your mouse cursor. You can even rearrange the order in which the mounts show up on the radial menu. What's more is that if you're in a body of water and you press your keybind, it knows that you cannot summon your raptor, for example, and will automatically summon a skimmer instead. Same if you are in World vs. World, in which case it will always summon a warclaw. Another feature of Guild Wars 2 Radial is that it will queue a summon for you. For example, I'm in combat here and I have queued up a sky scale. As soon as I get out of combat, it will summon a sky scale for me. This has been incredibly helpful in some sticky situations I have found myself in. Next is Arc DPS. Guild Wars 2 does not have an inbuilt DPS meter to show you how much damage you are putting out. Arc DPS meets that need. I feel like knowing how much or how little value you are contributing to your group motivates you to perform better. If you press Alt Shift D, it will bring up the Arc DPS menu. Here you can click on the area stats to check your DPS by default, but you can also click on the 1, 2, 3 and 4 checkboxes for some extra stats. All you have to do to set them up is right click on the box and go to advanced stats and click on what you want to see, like condition cleanses or boon strips or break bar damage and much more. You can also click on the boon table to see the boon uptime in your squad or party. I don't necessarily have Arc DPS on all the time, but it definitely comes in handy when I want to test out a new build. Next is Blish HUD. When you install and run Blish HUD, it will show you this icon next to your trading post icon in-game. This is where you set up Blish HUD to your needs. Clicking on it brings up the settings. When you go to Module Repository, you can check out all the different modules that the community of Guild Wars 2 has built. The one I will be talking about is Pathing. You can just click on Install and head over to Manage Modules, Pathing, Open Settings, Download Marker Packs, and download the various marker packs available. I have downloaded Tekkit's all-in-one marker pack, for example. If I then head over to Markers and Trails icon, next to the Blish HUD icon, I can select the markers that I need, like the map completion or jumping puzzles or achievements and so many others. Here I have the map completion trail ticked, and now it shows me the trail that I need to follow for 100% map completion. Although this is by no means a comprehensive list of various add-ons available, these are one of my favorites and I cannot imagine playing the game without these. For Arc DPS and Guild Wars 2 Radial, you only need to download Guild Wars 2 Add-on Manager, while for Blish HUD you will have to download that separately. I will put the links to download and install these add-ons in the description down below. Thanks for watching.